Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how to use the Do Not Disturb mode on your iPhone. So your iPhone makes a lot of noise. You get phone calls, you're going to get alerts, notifications, and all that stuff. And during the day, and when you're just going about your regular business, that's fine. You want to know about these things. But at night when you're sleeping, or say if you're in a meeting or you're giving a presentation or something, then you want your iPhone to be quiet. And there's a specific setting for this called Do Not Disturb mode. And it's very easy to use. Matter of fact, you can just turn it on yourself. Say if you're about to go into a meeting, you don't want to be disturbed, you can swipe up from the bottom to bring up the control center. And then you see the icon there that's the little crescent moon? That's the Do Not Disturb button. Tap that and it turns on Do Not Disturb mode. Likewise, you can tap it to turn it off when the meeting is over. So what happens when you have Do Not Disturb mode on? Well, you're not going to get any noise and any sound from your phone. One of the few things that gets through are alarms. So if you're using this at night and you've set an alarm for the morning, don't worry, the alarm will sound. So if you go into the clock app and set an alarm, that will sound. But other things will be silent. Now there's even more to it than that. Let's go into settings. And you'll see Do Not Disturb as one of the settings categories with the same icon there. We'll go in and you've got a switch at the top where you can turn it on manually. Same thing as what we just did in the control center. But you can also set a schedule. So you can turn on scheduled. I have it set to on and I have it set to go from 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. So it automatically goes into Do Not Disturb mode during those hours. I can tap on there and change those to any hours, any times I want. You could also decide to allow some calls to get through, like either from favorites or from groups. You can't create contact groups on the iPhone, of course. You have to create them on a Mac, but once you do and set those up in iCloud, then they'll show up here. So you can have, say, a few people in a group and set that group to allow calls from here, and then you'll hear from them. Another way to deal with that, with emergency calls and things, is you see where it says repeated calls? If you turn that on, then what happens is if somebody calls twice within 3 minutes, the second one will go through. So you can let important people in your life know that if they need to reach you and it's nighttime or you just don't answer your phone, try again immediately and you may actually be there. You just might have Do Not Disturb mode turned on. You can also decide that you only want Do Not Disturb mode to be active when the iPhone is locked. So if it's sitting on your desk and you have it unlocked, but Do Not Disturb mode is active, then it will act like Do Not Disturb mode is not active. So you can choose either of those two modes. Depends how you use your iPhone.